QED is an initialism of the Latin phrase quod erat demonstrandum, originating from the Greek analogous hector cubed per a copyright deîxai registered trademark xi, meaning, which had to be demonstrated. The phrase is traditionally placed in its abbreviated form at the end of a mathematical proof or philosophical argument when what was specified in the enunciation a euro, and in the setting out a euro has been exactly restated as the conclusion of the demonstration. The abbreviation thus signals the completion of the proof. An example of QED signifying the successful completion of a geometry proof is available in Chapter 2 of the Wikibooks Geometry text. Etymology and early use. The phrase quod erat demonstrandum is a translation into Latin from the Greek a one-half I euro I micron I a one-quarter I micron I to the first I micro I three-quarters I plus or minus I to the first. Translating from the Latin into English yields what was to be demonstrated. However, translating the Greek phrase a one-half I euro I micron I a one-quarter I micron I to the first I micro I three-quarters I plus or minus I to the first produces a slightly different meaning. Since the verb I micron I one-half I one-quarter I to the first also means to show or to prove, a better translation from the Greek would read, the very thing it was required to have shown. The phrase was used by many early Greek mathematicians, including Euclid and Archimedes. Modern philosophy. In the European Renaissance, scholars often wrote in Latin, and phrases such as QED were often used to conclude proofs. Perhaps the most famous use of QED in a philosophical argument is found in the Ethics of Baruch Spinoza, published posthumously in 1677. Written in Latin, it is considered by many to be Spinoza's magnum opus. The style and system of the book is, as Spinoza says, demonstrated in geometrical order, with axioms and definitions followed by propositions. For Spinoza, this is a considerable improvement over René Copyright Descartes' writing style in the Meditations, which follows the form of a diary. QEF, there is another Latin phrase with a slightly different meaning, and less common in usage. Quod erat faciendum, originating from the Greek geometers closing a one-half I euro I micron I a one-quarter I micron I to the first I euro I to the first I florin I plus or minus I to the first, meaning, which had to be done. Euclid used this phrase to close propositions which were not proofs of theorems, but constructions. For example, Euclid's first proposition shows how to construct an equilateral triangle given one side. It is usually shortened to QEF. Equivalents in other languages, QED has acquired many translations in various languages, including, there is no common formal English equivalent, though the end of a proof may be announced with a simple statement such as this completes the proof, as required, hence proved, ergo, or a similar locution. www or w5, an abbreviation of, which was what was wanted has also been used. This is often considered to be more tongue-in-cheek than the usual HAMO symbol or QED, electronic forms. When typesetting was done by a compositor with letterpress printing, complex typography such as mathematics and foreign languages were called penalty copy. With the advent of systems such as LaTeX, mathematicians found their options more open, so there are several symbolic alternatives in use either in the input, the output, or both. When creating text, Newt provided the symbol A, also called by mathematicians tombstone or HAMO symbol. The tombstone is sometimes open, A. Unicode explicitly provides the end of proof character U plus 220E, but also offers a registered trademark and a euro pound as alternatives. Some authors have adopted variants of this notation with other symbols, such as two forward slashes, or simply some vertical white space, implying no further statements need to be made in the proof. Modern humorous usage, QED is sometimes jokingly claimed to abbreviate quite easily done. In Joseph Heller's book Catch 22, the chaplain, having been told to examine a forged letter allegedly signed by him, verified that his name was in fact there. His investigator replied, "Then you wrote it." QED, the chaplain said he didn't write it and that it wasn't his handwriting, but the investigator's faulty logic caused him to point out, "Then you signed your name in somebody else's handwriting again." Thomas Dolby, in his 1988 song Airhead, imagines a conversation with the titular young woman and says quod erat demonstrandum, baby, to which she squeals the eager reply, oh, you speak French. In Chapter 6 of The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, by Douglas Adams, QED is included in the following exchange. The argument goes something like this: I refuse to prove that I exist, says God, for proof denies faith, and without faith I am nothing. But, says man, the Babel fish is a dead giveaway, isn't it? It could not have evolved by chance. It proves you exist, and so therefore, by your own arguments, you don't. QED. Oh dear, says God, I hadn't thought of that, and promptly vanishes in a puff of logic. Another potential English transliteration is in the movie Ice Princess. Michelle Trachtenberg's lead character Casey is a physics nerd who writes a paper on the physics of figure skating, concluding she has shown passion for the topic, QED, to which her best friend replies, what has been quite easily demonstrated. In the mid-80s, BBC ran a series called QED, which showed how certain things were made or put together. Danny and Lee, authors of the famous Ellery Queen mystery novels, often had their protagonist refer to his solving of the murder case as Queen's elementary deduction. In Justice League, Crisis on Two Earths, the supervillain OWLMAN names the bomb that he intends to use to destroy the multiverse the quantum eigenstate device, which he abbreviates as QED. In the 1987 movie No Way Out, Will Patton's character Scott Pritchard proved that Kevin Costner's character, Lieutenant CMDR Tom Farrell, was a double agent named Yuri. Afterwards he said quod erat demonstrandum. See also, a priori and a posteriori, list of Latin abbreviations, references. External links, earliest known uses of some of the words of mathematics.